In this tutorial, we are going to create our first widget for Magento 2, and it's going to be a showcase widget for your landing page. Hello friends, my name is Max Promko, I'm Magento YouTuber. I create various tutorials on how to customize and work with Magento 2 by building custom themes, custom extensions, third-party integrations, and so on. If you are new here, smash this subscribe button, hit like, and let me know in the comments below what you think, what are your questions. I would try to answer them in my next tutorials. So in this tutorial, I would like to show you how we can create a custom widget for Magento 2. And as you may remember from my previous tutorials about how to build a custom theme, I created a block, CMS block, and I wanted to show this block with a background image. And this block should have a title and subtitle inside. So this is a result of my work in terms of CMS block or CMS part, and I decided to went ahead and to create a widget, CMS widget instead of block. It would allow to avoid mistakes from an admin point of view. So instead of creating or changing HTML markup and content, and it's important, for example, if there is admin user which has no experience with HTML markup, it would be hard for him or her to understand that there is a closing tag which should remain in this markup. And in most cases, you would have to educate your admin people to know markup, HTML markup. Instead of this approach, we could provide them a very simple form, and this form could be a widget with just a field where they can add information. So in my case, for a banner widget, all that admin user has to provide is title and subtitle, and possibility to select a template if there is more than one option for design or for a template. So I will show you how. As a result, I have exactly the same widget, however, I can use it. Yeah, so this, I created a test page and added a widget. As you can see, it's a widget. I will have to work on logo or image of this, placeholder of this widget. However, as an example, you would get an idea. So when admin would like to add a hero or showcase banner, he would go add insert widget to a CMS block or page, and will select widget type Promko banner, and there are going to be a couple of options which I showed, title and subtitle. Yes, so as a result, we can have this nicely styled widget, and admin would never save a broken HTML from admin panel. So let's have a look how I created. First of all, if you follow my theme tutorials, this is a first video in a custom theme where I decided, instead of customizing and showing a theme repository, I decided to build a Magento 2 extension, and this extension is responsible for adding a custom widget. So I created this new module called banner widget, and there are a couple of important things you have to know in order to create custom widget, in this case a banner widget. First of all, you have to create a module.xml file, which is a required module for all Magento 2 extensions, and in sequence, as a dependency, you have to add Magento_widget. It would allow when you will set up this module, it would allow to position your module in a proper order in a config.php file. So meaning that configuration of Pronko underscore banner widget depends on configuration of Magento underscore widget module. Next one, you have to create widget.xml file where you would position your widget configuration. So this is you can find available or possible nodes in widget.xsd file, but we're not going to go deep into XSDs. I will just explain you what I created. So I have widget node with my custom ID, custom class, which I have to create, and I created it. Placeholder image, it's optional. And couple of things like label of a widget, description if necessary, if it's a complex widget, and three parameters, title, subtitle, and template. There is also a single option, a PHTML file or template of a widget. So this is template you can allow admin user to select. So in this case, it's only one. However, we can add more templates in the future, and admin user can select different templates. So as for block, it's an empty class. Since we don't have any custom functionality or logic or calculation or any algorithms, we don't need to have any extra methods in this class. However, it's important to create this class and extend from Magento widget block interface. This is a requirement for all widgets. So this class has to implement widget block interface. Then I also have an image, placeholder image. So when I will be using inserting widget, admin will insert widget, this presentation, visual presentation inside a page will show this placeholder. And I place this placeholder under view, admin HTML, web images, and here is a placeholder. Also, as for template, I place this template under view frontend templates, widget banner, showcase, and there are two variables. As you can see, it's a markup which I copy-paste from my CMS block. So previously it was a CMS block, now it's a template of a widget, and for dynamic parts like titles and subtitle, I use block getData method, and I return title and subtitle from the configuration or from the widget configuration. This is basically it for the widget. So widgets are more user-friendly for Magento admin users. They would help to avoid any typos in HTML markup, any broken pages, and for admin user it would be more handy to just see a simple form where he or she could add necessary information and add as many widgets as it's required for a page. I also created a repository if you would like to check this widget. It's on GitHub under MCS Pronko banner widget, and you can read all the documentation and on how to install, how to use, and how to customize this extension. So this is it for today's tutorial. Let me know in the comments below what you think about widgets as a functionality in Magento 2, where it can be improved. Maybe you want me to explain more about widgets. And don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in my next videos. Bye.